Georgia men's 62 kilograms European weightlifting championship final, and we are joining the action already into the snatch competition. Well, there are a number of weightlifters taking part in today, 9 in total. Probably the biggest name of all, Valentin Ristov from Azerbaijan, formerly from Bulgaria, has returned from a drugs ban. Just 2 days to spare. Well, Russia, in the form of Pavel Sukhanov, coming out at 130 kilograms. This is his third and final lift. So missing that one there, a little disappointing. One lift to come, and hit 125 in his opener. He's currently ranked third, and we still have around about 10 lifts to come in this snatch competition before we move on to the clean and jerk. Well, posting big starting weights was the likes of Ristov, who of course has European records at under 23 level in the 56 kilo category. Not at this heavier weight category. He has to be the big favorite for today. And this is how it stands at the moment. Kroitoru, 128, successful with his first lift. A lot of lifters already have done all three. Still waiting to see Ristov join in. Alongside me, Colin Bryce. Mikaela Breeze, Mikaela. This is quite a tight category. Unless Ristov, which we haven't seen for 2 years, is absolutely on fire.
Yeah, we're not sure what shape he's going to be in, having just come back from a 2-year suspension. Who knows what he's going to come out with. He's posted a 133. Let's see if he can stick to that and nail it. But it's going to be a tight competition for the gold, silver, and also for the bronze medal. It's going to be a good fight between all of these athletes.
Sukhanov goes for 130 again, and it's a good lift.
It was a much more convincing third attempt compared to his second. His second attempt looked a bit sluggish, lacking in terms of explosiveness, but that was a really good recovery. Sukhanov was European under 23 champion back in 2011, so he's risen through the ranks. He is the national champion at the moment. His first appearances on the senior stage. See how deep he sits into that squat position. Great recovery.
Bunyami Sezer, veteran Turkish lifter, former European champion, fourth last year, though actually he was bumped up to third when one of the Bulgarians was pulled. So very solid lifter indeed. Snatch up to 140 when he's on form. Last year's European Championships was won with 136. That was Ivelo Filev.
Oh, lacking legs through the middle. Very, very strong off the floor, but if you don't get that extension, you don't generate the upward momentum on the bar. Never nice to miss your first attempt. It puts the pressure straight on. All these lifters have to get one snatch and one clean and jerk to register a total. We miss all three, bomb out, no result. Just a little short through the extension. Obviously a weight you can manage. 142 is his absolute best.
Cesare snatched 142 when he got the gold back in Antalya at the European Championships, so a long way down on what he's been in the past now. Valentin Ristov, here he is. A young man who has served a 2-year ban. Believe it or not, it started on April 10th, 2013, so he's just made it back. It's a 2-year ban by a couple of days and no more. Lifting for Azerbaijan.
Well, he's a lifter that's been working hard in those 2 years. That was convincing, that was dynamic. 133, he's in the competition. How much further can he go?
Quite a lot further looking at that anyway. That's quite impressive. very snappy for a man who's not been on the international stage for quite some time. He might have been ring rusty, he might have been nervous, but not a bit of it. Cesaire under a little bit of pressure now. He did something similar at the Olympics when he came out and put himself under massive pressure in London, missing his opener. Now 134, he's gone up a kilogram, trying to buy himself a little time.
Was better in the competition. Cesaire has much experience on this kind of stage. Fourth last year, but he has held the title back in 2012 and 2011. I'm sure he's going to want to improve on the fourth place from last year and get himself back on the podium at least. It was a cracking second attempt, great recovery. I'm sure there's much more there though. Looking a little bit in the leg strength. Weighed in at 61.74, so he's probably had to shift a few kilos in body weight to make weight.
Florin Croitoru of Romania now, 22 years old. At 128, then 132. This to go 3 out of 3 in the snatch.
Well, that buzzer, I think it was a 30-second buzzer. It's okay. See him shaking. My goodness me, doesn't he look better this year? He was champion last year, but in the lighter category, 56 categories, moved up to 62. He looks like he's filled out a lot more. He looks a lot healthier and in really good shape. I wonder if he can establish himself in this category.
Well, shaky, but arms not bending. Nothing wrong with that at all. So 3 out of 3 for Croitoru. His wrist off. A whole load of the Bulgarians moved over to Azerbaijan in 2011. And I guess a good thing for him, because of course the entire Bulgarian team has been withdrawn due to a number 11 to be exact of positive A samples in drug testing in the last few weeks. So, different country, Bulgarian born, of course. Extremely good athlete. His personal best, 141, still a long way off of that. It's just 2 kilograms up from his first lift.
Not the best technically, throws his head back, that will consequently throw his shoulders back, but he lands it, and when he lands it, it's a solid lift. 2 out of 2, there's only a 2 kilo increase. Just got to wonder how much further he's going to go. Not many lifters left in the competition. He will want a gold medal on the snatch.
Well, certainly look like there's a lot more there. Now Cesaire coming out. 141 his personal best, 136 this, and that 141 still stands as an under 23 European record. Amazing, at 26 years old, almost the oldest man in the field, just Dudoglu a little bit older.
Army as he came off the floor, you can see his arms were bent before the bar even got to his knees. That's going to pull him onto his toes. He just couldn't recover from there. It's important as you come off the floor that the weight is through flat feet so you can fully extend upwards. It's a shame he's going to be kicking himself. That would have put him right up there in the mix. He's going to be lucky to hang on to a medal. Launching the path forwards, at least he grabbed hold of it before it shot off towards the referees.
Well, it's just a wrist off now to come out and do something big. I wonder what he's going to do.
Well, he's got nothing to lose here. He's got the gold on the snatch. He's also got he's got the highest posted start weight on the clean and jerk. So is he going to play safe and go a couple of kilos, or is he going to go for something big?
Well, 141 is his personal best. I think he's actually going even heavier here. 142, a 7 kilogram increase. And my goodness, Ristoff is back with a bang. He's got the gold medal already around his neck. Last lift in the snatch.
Not today. That was psychological, not through lack of strength.
I think that would have got him Cesare's under 23 European record. That's why he went for 1-4-2.
Well, bar was plenty high enough. As I said before in a previous competition, you don't need the bar to be coming up that high. He should have been under it much, much quicker.
1-4-2, a failure, sadly. It was a big old jump, 7 kilograms, but he's got the gold medal, 1 kilogram ahead of Croitoru of Romania, Cesare of Turkey, equal on weight, but by virtue of body weight, he's a few grams heavier, so he must settle for the bronze there. Next up, the clean and jerk. Welcome back to Tbilisi, Georgia, European Championships of Weightlifting. And the break is over into the clean and jerk. We had the snatch earlier. 135 kilograms was the winner for Valentin Ristov of Azerbaijan. Dudoglu of Moldova coming out to kick us off here. 141 kilograms on the bar. Well over 300 pounds. He only did 124 in the snatch. Disappointing for him there.
Talking about attacking the bar, and he does that as the bar passes the knees, really accelerates, explodes into it. That's where all the force and power is generated. These guys look in proportion, but they're actually very, very short, very compact, sub 62 kilo body weight. See the acceleration through the second phase, big drive to arm's length. Really good first, solid opening attempt.
Coming out for Ukraine now, Bogdan Tokar. Did 121, three good lifts in the snatch, 116, 119, 121. He's behind Dudoglu already. Probably just happy to be up in the A group. This will take him ahead of all of the B group lifters who went earlier.
Well, he's just looking around. The reason he's looking around is because the clock hadn't started ticking.
Well, the biggest start weight is 160. Valentin Ristov, who won the snatch, has posted a massive start weight.
Well, very dynamic on the jerk, split position, spot on. If you can nail it like that, the bar over the shoulders, shoulders over the hips, keeps the back and the shoulders nice and safe, nicely on balance. Position here, really good extension on the clean. Just adjust, takes his time, a little bit of oscillation on the bar. He's got away with it though. No problems there.
Well, backstage, they're all in different stages of their warm-up. I suppose Valentin Ristov has barely done much more than the bar at the moment, because his opener at 160, if he really does come out at that, well, just about every other lift will have come before we get there. The next highest start total at 153. Cesaire and Sukhanov. That's what they're expected to come in at. There is Cesaire. Finished third in the snatch. 134. He's only a kilogram behind Ristov. So still a good battle going into this clean and jerk.
Once these athletes start loading the bar in the warm-up room, it takes around 15, 16 minutes to go from an empty bar up to top weight. The lifters will probably take about 6, 7, maybe 8 attempts to get there. They need to time their warm-up to perfection. That's the coach's job. Make sure they get to the platform at the right time.
Doglu. Second lift, 145.
Tremendous speed. Slightly in front of the bar as he comes off the floor. But he has tremendous back strength to be able to compensate. One of the most dynamic lifters we've seen so far in these championships. Acceleration through the middle. Stands up strong. And these guys and the girls will be squatting every single day, breakfast, lunch and dinner, to try and get these legs as super strong as possible to make that part of the lift as efficient as possible. Standing up from the bottom, from the deep squat position, is so important.
Emra Aydin, one of two Turks in the competition, 146 is opener. So give him a 269 total and put him into second behind Dudoglu. He did a 1-2-3 snatch.
Well, Aydin is the next in the long line of weightlifters that come through the Turkish ranks. He's got to be inspired by his teammate, Cesar, who has led the way on the international stage for the last few years. But he's got something to aspire to, something to work towards, and it's great to have that kind of competition in your home country. And only 18 years of age.
Yeah, unbelievable.
You'd expect to see rapid improvements at this kind of age as he's still filling out, still developing. This is when the body is highest naturally with testosterone. So he's going to be expecting some big gains over the next few years. Let's see how close he can get to his teammate.
His personal best, 150 in the clean and jerk. Now, Tokar, his PB, 155. Going for 146 here.
Short on the extension, but manages to get underneath quick enough. Really good overhead. Precision is there. Needs to find some more legs if he's going to succeed with any more, though.
5 out of 5 for Tokar. 267 his total. It might be worth him going to 150 next. Certainly has the power in the legs. 155 PB as well. It seems a little underweight at the moment.
That's it. If he cleans it, you've got to put money on him jerking it.
That was the Romanian, Florin Croitoru, for 148 his opener. He did 3 out of 3 in the snatch. 134 gave him second place. We know from previous form that he doesn't have the kind of clean and jerk to match it with Ristov, especially if Ristov really does come out at 160 in the opener. He has done 157 in the past, Croitoru.
Oh, drifted onto his left leg as he dipped. Good leg strength though, and it's good to see him really establishing himself already in these ranks. Silver medal after the snatch. And he's always complaining of a tweak in the elbow. I'm sure that'll be fine. This level, this kind of platform, full of adrenaline. Adrenaline's by far the best painkiller. Good drive to arm's length. And yeah, he's come through the ranks already. In just 1 year to establish yourself on this kind of platform is excellent training, excellent work.
Didn't even go that deep in the squat, did he? It's a flexibility issue. Some of the athletes can go almost down to the platform. It's phenomenal. Now, Dadoglu, 149, 4 kilograms up. One kilogram away from his personal best.
Ooh, has to work a bit harder there. Good drive to arm's length. I think that's probably a sensible call in terms of weight. He's right on the limit there. 3 out of 3.
273 his total. That ranks him in second place, though. Now we still have another number of big lifters to come, so probably bumped well down the order by the time this is finished. Good solid lifting. A shame he doesn't have another lift, really. 150 is PB. Would have been fun to have seen him try and crack that. Bogdan Takar, 149. This will give him 6 out of 6.
Well, that's Tucker's first appearance on a senior international platform, and he's just come out and nailed 6 out of 6. That's good experience that he would have gained from this championships, and I'm sure we're going to see bigger and better things from him in the future.
He's 6 out of 6 on the international stage. Certainly shows he has a very cool head. I'd also say he was a little too conservative. Perhaps there was more there.
Here's our Commonwealth Games champion from last year, Dimitris Minasidis.
The Cypriot, who did 127. In his third snatch, having missed it on his second, comes out for 150, his opener in the clean and jerk.
Not many lifters we see attempting a squat jerk. Why? Because it takes a ridiculous amount of flexibility in the shoulders, and you have to be spot on in terms of precision. That was not spot on. Just drifted forwards as he dipped. You just see it from the side, really. Works hard on the clean.
I mean, I guess it would be fair to say the squat jerk, if you can do it perfectly, it would be the strongest position for your legs to be in, but stand back up with it, but it's so hard to get right, isn't it?
Oh, it's so hard, and you need to have a phenomenal amount of leg strength. To stand with a clean is hard enough. To then have to stand again from a squat jerk position is even harder, and that's why you don't see many athletes attempting it.
Kagani Suki from Hungary didn't do so well in the snatch. 119 his best. That left him right down the bottom of the A group. He is only 21 years old. Clean and jerk, much better at this. Did 145 in the European Championships last year. So this will be a big improvement.
There's the power jerk.
Well, we're getting to see them all here. Power jerks only needs really strong legs to do that.
Well, to do a power jerk, you have to drive the bar so much higher than you would if you were doing a split jerk. So this is probably the least efficient, but he clearly has the leg strength, leg drive to stand with it. I've got to question why he's not doing a split jerk.
Yeah, it too needs flexibility, doesn't it?
Yeah, I mean, you know, different lifters have their reasons. He's obviously able to execute that quite comfortably, but I thought the clean was very, very strong. I think there's a lot more there. But as you said, only 21 years of age. We'll see how he develops and whether or not he resorts back to a split jerk. These athletes will train a split jerk, even though they do a power or a squat.
Out comes the 18-year-old again. Let's see what Emrah Aydin can do. 1-5-1 on the bar. This will take him up to second place overall.
Steps forward, just needs to steady himself, show that he's under control, and he is. 1-5-1. He looks strong for more. I think we could see another few kilos added to the bar for his final attempt.
Yeah, 3 kilos of improvements what he did in the snatch on his personal best. So who knows, maybe he'll even go for 1-5-5 more. Why not? So unlikely to win a medal now, so he might as well just rack up his personal best total. Still yet to see Valentin Ristov come in. Still expecting him around the 160 kilogram mark. Welcome back to Tbilisi. Minasidis of Cyprus upped his weight to 152, having missed 150. A little bit of a gamble. But 170 is his best clean and jerk. So it still should be comfortable.
That's better. Still has to take a step forward. I know that Minasidis has suffered in the last few years with knee injuries, with elbow injuries. Seems to be holding it together quite well today, looking all right.
He'll be happy with that. Takes his total up to just shy of 280 kilograms. Let's have a look from the side here. Well, from the front again anyway. He does. Is it just in front of him? I think he's just rocking onto his toes a bit. So tricky, as you said, Mikhaila, to do that kind of movement. Now, Cesare, Bunyami Cesare, coming out at 1-5-3. Only did one good snatch, that was 1-34. Missed his 1-36.
At all in the drive. You can see him just taking his time to get off the platform. That bar looked to be sitting heavy on his windpipe. Very difficult to get the oxygen in.
I see what you mean about the bent arms from the snatch. He does it as well when he starts to go off the floor here.
It's not technically very efficient. We see here the arms are bent. That means the legs are limited in terms of how much drive they can exert. And the legs and glutes is where all the power comes from. Nonetheless, he stood with a clean. Just no drive. He dipped and almost split straight away.
Russian, Pavel Sukhanov, 153 also. He's good for 163 at his very best. If he gets this, he'll go up into first.
Well, there's a lifter again struggling with leg drive today, but his speed makes up for it. He's in the competition, he'll be able to necessarily relax, but the pressure is off in terms of making a total. Cesar, Bunyami Cesar of Turkey, however, still has to get himself on the board.
Yes, Sukhanov, he's a good lifter on paper, and 130 in the snatch has left him 4 kilos behind the likes of Cesar and 5 behind Ristov, who leads after the snatch phase. And he's the one athlete we haven't seen yet in this clean and jerk competition. His starting weight, 160, still posted as that now. Here's the Romanian again, Florin Poitoru.
Oh, see the body shaking, and he's gone. That's on the windpipe. That's a shame. Always gutting when that happens. You stand with a lift, but if the bar is sat on the windpipe, you just can't get the oxygen in. Very hard to breathe. You go dizzy. You start to black out. I'm sure we'll see a good recovery from him on his third attempt.
Yeah, surprisingly, you can recover pretty quickly from it, can't you?
Oh yeah, yeah. It's not an issue. But when it goes like that, there's nothing you can do. Your body starts quivering under the bar.
Yeah, I mean, it's not good if you follow yourself straight away, but there's a couple of lifters between him. And of course, Cesar missed 153, so he's definitely got some time here. Yeah! Cesar's decided not to go up.
Drive. Well, Bunyami Cesar is now in some serious trouble under a lot of pressure, and if he comes out the way he's just done there, it's going to be hard pushed to get a third attempt in. He needs to find some legs, needs to drive much higher, right through the bar on the jerk. Clean doesn't seem to be too much of a problem. Here he just doesn't drive high enough. See where that bar is, he needs to drive through that starting position to have any chance of driving it to arm's length.
Well, two confidence-cracking attempts for Cesar. What's he going to do? Go up? He's got a little time here because, of course, Poitoru failed 153 as well, so he's going to come back out for that. If he gets it, he'll go up to 287, and he'll be in the lead. Overall.
Still see him shaking under it. Wow, he did well to recover. Had the down signal, but still took a second to steady himself. Well, that was a big effort. Not quite up to where he's been in the past. 157 is his best. You can see he had to work hard there today.
He hobbles off the stage, and goodness.
See the whole body shaking underneath the bar. Managed to maintain his composure.
That's the kind of lift when you've got it overhead, it can just get away from you, can't it? You've done it, you've made it, but get the down signal in time, it can slip away. Now big pressure here on Bunyami Cesar, former European champion.
Well, the best can do it when it matters. Can he dig deep enough? Can he remain composed? One attempt to try and get himself up onto that podium. This weight should be enough to do it.
He's gone up a kilogram.
Whether it's going to be enough for a medal on the clean and jerk, time will tell.
It'll take take him into first. Yeah! Anyway, a kilogram ahead of the Romanian.
Needs to drive. Only just.
How gutsy was that? Great performance from Cesare, and he's disappointed, but he certainly pulled it out of the bag on his third lift there. A real test of character. 288 kilograms, he's up in the lead in first place, and stands a very good chance of being on the podium now.
Well, he does. That was a really gutsy effort. Had to dig so deep for this. Only just to arm's length. I think another half a kilo and he'd have probably missed it again. It was gutsy as well to even go up by 1 kilo. But he's not happy with that. It was a good recovery.
The FIM Speedway World Championships, live on British Eurosport.
You can't take your eyes off it.
Powered by Methanol.
Sensational action.
0 to 60 in 2 seconds.
What a ride!
And no brakes.
Oh!
It's raw entertainment.
This is one heck of a Speedway race.
Whoa! Round 1, Warsaw. Saturday, 6 p.m. Live on British Eurosport 2 HD.
Skoda Octavia, winner of What Car Family Car of the Year 2015. It's not your everyday family car. Visit your local Skoda retailer to test drive the Octavia range.
Skoda, simply clever.
Let's have a look.
Which one do you want to watch?
What do you just want to watch?
Go on, family.
Comedy.
Superhero.
Sci-fi.
Not a rom-com.
Where's your remote?
Gonna break it?
No.
Yes, Guardians of the Galaxy.
Transformers.
Oh, Maleficent.
It's either this one or this one.
What about that one, though?
Seen it.
That's the new one.
Give it 10 minutes.
Everyone else watch a film. Go back.
Rock, paper, scissors.
Power.
That's the one.
So we agree?
Yeah.
Yeah, that one.
Finally.
Be spoilt for choice with over 1,000 great movies on demand. Sky Movies.
Now the action continues here in Tbilisi, European Weightlifting Championships, men's 62 kilo category. And we're still waiting for Valentin Ristov to come out and do his opening clean and jerk. Everybody else has already come out for at least one. Gageli Suki, 150, the young Hungarian, now going for 155. He does have a fantastic clean and jerk, though sadly his snatch lets him down. This will only take him up to fifth overall.
Has to work hard to stand. What? Not today. Maybe a little dizzy. He still has one attempt remaining. This would be a personal best by 1 kilo if successful.
Yeah, at the moment he's down in eighth position. It's not about the total. It would only take him up to fifth, but if he gets this 155, he certainly looks like he'll get a medal in the clean and jerk. Right now, he looks more likely to get sixth or seventh. Emrah Aydin, the 18-year-old Amazing, he could be sitting his A-levels. 155 kilograms for his third and final. He gets this. Well, I think he'll be guaranteed a medal, actually, in the clean and jerk, or very close to it. The weak snatch will leave him lagging in the total.
He's just seen his teammate manage 154. And he's coming through the ranks and he's thrown the gauntlet open and said, come on then, 155. Great lifting, that's a 5 kilo personal best. And he's up on the podium at the moment. Time will tell if he can stay there, but he's in a really, really good position. And it's great to see youngsters coming through on this kind of level. Good, strong clean, maintains a nice straight back, right up to arm's length. A few steps forward to steady himself. He's got it.
Yes, he's not guaranteed actually for a third. He could be bumped down to fourth position. It's possible. We still have the Russian Sukhanov, Ristov, and Manasidis all with lifts in the clean and jerk. Cesaire, the senior of the two, he's 27 years old, had to settle for 154. Will be beaten by his young teammate, Aideen. Though, of course, not for the overall. Just in the clean and jerk. Now, here's the Hungarian, 155. He looks so good at 150. His last attempt.
Speed. Does he have the legs to drive to arm's length? Not to be. What a shame. That's the problem when you end up going from a power jerk sitting into a squat jerk. Technically, he hasn't warmed up doing a squat jerk. So his first attempt on the platform was a power jerk. Now he's on a weight that he cannot manage for a power. He has to sit in. That's the first time he's been down there. And I think it's a crazy way of warming up to suddenly change the position you're in on the platform. And you see athletes doing it in the warm-up, they'll power snatch to warm up, and as the weight gets heavier, they sit in deeper and deeper until they get to the platform and they're then in a full position. But they haven't warmed up doing it, so.
Absolutely, I mean, even the lightest weights, you should almost pretend they're your max. And
the position should be the same.
The exact routine every time.
The only difference is the effort you put in. So on a lightweight, same position, same speed, just less effort.
Now, Manasidis of Cyprus, this would be big for him if he gets 156. Look at his body weight there, 62.00. He just made it in. Not a gram to spare in the weigh-in. This will guarantee him a medal in the clean and jerk.
What a short on the extension. Speed under the bar was good. Is it straight enough? Yes, it is. Ooh, steady. Yeah, happy with that.
Don't let it out too early. Haven't been given the down signal before the first scream there, but all good. 156 it is. His overall total, 283. So he's definitely not on the podium overall, especially with Ristov still to come in. Probably more likely down to fifth, but a very good chance of getting one of the medals. In fact, he's guaranteed it. Could even be silver, you never know, depending on what Ristov does. What is Ristov going to come in at?
Not sure. We still have Sukhanov with one attempt as well, two attempts remaining.
Yeah, 153 looked really comfortable for the Russian. And here he is. 5 kilograms up. This will take him up to second overall. He'll lead the clean and jerk.
Ooh, don't know. Right elbow. His right, our left as we look at it. I thought there was movement there.
Well, that would be a tough one. He gets the white light from the center judge. centre referee, but no, 2-1. So he's going to have to come out and do that again. Let's have a look.
No problems with the clean, that was fine. No oscillation.
Yeah.
There was movement. Centre referee should have failed that. Probably one of the side referees you would let off not spotting it. But
I mean, it's not exactly a lot of flexing. I mean, hardly pressed it out, did he? But you know, as per the rules.
He will know what he's done. He won't be arguing the case. He knows there was movement there. He would have felt it.
I mean, in many ways, the rules there really just stop someone pressing it out, isn't it? But you'd hardly say that was a press out. It was just a wobble, really.
Yes. A press out, we tend to think, is partway up, and then you carry on extending. He almost went, I don't know.
He went to full extension,
there was
and
movement.
Just, yeah, it kicked back.
That's it. And on these kind of weights, you cannot control that movement. It happens so quickly, the bar's either there or it's not. Now the coach is asking the question, come on, what are we doing? Taking the same weight again, or do you need more time? If you need more time, we need to put the bar up by a kilo. What's he going to come out on? Same weight, what do you reckon?
Well, I think he's gone up. 159 is what's gone on to the bar, and wrist off, still not in. So when Sukhanov has done this, we will get to see Valentin Ristov. He won the snatch, come out with... well, no one else will have lifts left. So, to take him to first in the clean and jerk from probably sixth. Big moment.
Still blowing. He's still out of breath and hasn't used the time to his full advantage. Clean was good. It's a shame. Finishes down in sixth, well, fifth at the moment, but more than likely sixth after Ristov comes out in a minute.
Yeah, ranked third overall, and as you said, yeah, probably going to get bumped now because Valentin Ristov, he's going to come out and do 160, and if he does that, he's taken the whole competition and all of the golds as well, so it could be just one more lift. Now he's got three if he needs it.
Well, we see the celebrations here from the Turkish team with that lift just going to ground. Aydin of Turkey is guaranteed a medal on the jerk. The worst he can finish is third on the jerk. And his teammate, Cesar, is going to be at least silver. That's assuming that Ristov here nails his first attempt.
Yes, Cesar still in third place in the clean and jerk, still in first in the overall. Can Ristov take that away? This then, one lift, and he'll have all three golds. He'll be the European champion.
He has a personal best of 178, 18 kilos below. Don't expect anything less, do you?
Didn't hang about. He's the European champion again. He has served his time, if you like, from a ban for 2 years because of doping. And it ran out just a couple of days ago. Nice timing for him. And here he is, European champion again. And he certainly looks on supreme form, Ristov.
Yes, he does. Is he going to come out? Is he going to bother for his second and third attempts? He's already champion. He's so far down on his best. You've got to question what he would achieve by coming out again.
Yeah, I don't know, really. I mean, maybe just to blow off a little more rust from the platform, but he obviously doesn't have too much. Well, there is, on the left, Aydin, who gets the bronze medal in the clean and jerk. Cesar, the hirsute bearded one, he... has to settle for fourth in the clean and jerk, but silver in the overall, 288. So he's 7 kilograms behind Ristov in the end. He also gets a bronze in the snatch. Third place in the overall, it'll be Florin Croitoru of Romania. The Turks having an excellent weightlifting championships so far.
He's not coming out again. He's taking the tape off his thumbs. Job done. Time to go and eat. All of these athletes will enjoy some good food tonight, having had to cut body weight. Most of these athletes would train probably around 65, 66 kilos, so a good 3, maybe 4 kilos overweight, and then have to drop for the last few weeks. Just signing there the anti-doping form. He's been pulled for testing again. Let's hope results come back clear this time.
Yes, a former European champion Valentin Ristov, back in 2012, third at the Olympics. And Sabia now 2015, he's the European champion in the 62s. Just one clean and jerk. That was all he needed to take the gold in the clean and jerk. Some good lifting from some younger men, though, in the field. Certainly very promising for the likes of Emra Aydin, who got third there. Bronze in the clean and jerk for the 18-year-old. Amazing. And the total, Valentin Ristov, 135-160, a 295 total. He's done a lot more than that, but he didn't need it. Bunyami Cesar, well, he too's done more than 288. He got the silver in the end, and I think he'd be pretty pleased with that. Just 1 kilogram ahead of Florin Kroitoru, who had a couple of mistakes. Probably could have had the silver. Things have just gone a little different. Well, the one man we won't see on the overall total podium is Pavel Sukhanov of Russia, who hit such an easy 1.53 in the clean and jerk and then failed that 1.58 and 5.9. And he hardly failed the 1.58. Wasn't much of a problem, just a little flex of his arms once it was up there. And he wasn't given it. There's Bunyami Cesar winning his silver medal. Overall total on the right hand side, Florin Kroitoru of Romania, the 22-year-old. And this man, Valentin Ristov, you think he's been around a while, but he really hasn't. He's only 21 years old. Amazing. He was doing European under 23 records almost 3 years ago. Just such a phenomenal talent. And he is the winner, 295. Compare that to last year's total, Velo Filev of Bulgaria. He did a 299. Second place, yes, last year was Chadovic of Belarus, 293. Enev, also of Bulgaria, 286. Of course, the Bulgarians not here because of problems with doping this year. Sadly, the whole team has been withdrawn. Well, that's it. Men's 62, Valentin Ristov, champion again.